You gotta love the big reveal at the celebrity-studded Golden Globes, otherwise known as the Harvey Weinstein Enablers Club. Oprah for president. My goodness, is this the pinnacle of style over substance? Maybe not. It's so fantastic, though, after 2+ years of bemoaning that a reality TV star is the president, Democrats are panting at the thought of their favorite talk show host running in 2020. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. If you're wondering how far the obsession with the superficiality of the celebrity culture would go, well, consider that we turn to leading lights like Leonardo DiCaprio to talk the science of climate change, maybe from his yacht or mansion, but that's only when George Clooney isn't available from his yacht or mansion. Of course, we had Farrell, you know, the composer, Pharrell, I guess, the composer and former, performer of the song Happy at the United Nations, answering the public's questions on climate change. No scientists were needed when there's a celebrity around. And it was a relief for many when Sean Penn and Danny DeVito went to the Mideast to resolve the Israeli-Palestinian situation. And my personal favorite, as you'd expect, that we look to Bono and Russell Brand for their own childlike proclamations on economics. And of course, we have our own celebrity prime minister, but I wouldn't like his chances if Gord Downie had decided to run or Celine Dion throws her hat in the ring. Oh my gosh, what if Sidney Crosby decides politics is his calling? I mean, look out, because he's already shown great leadership skills. But I got to say that Canada is different from the U.S. Our celebrity name was elected in response to the previous government, maybe the seriousness of the Harper government. It was not seen as sufficiently progressive by many people, including in the press. And after 9 years, many wanted a change, including major U.S. environmental groups who claimed credit for defeating the conservatives in several ridings. But the U.S. is different. Donald Trump's election is a result of significant failures of the political class, both Republicans and Democrats. His election was the result of cronyism, incompetence, and above all, elitism that failed to understand, let alone address, the problems of a massive number of Americans. So no wonder they turned to Mr. Trump. Now, maybe Oprah, maybe to The Rock. I mean, how could you be worse as a response than what we've been getting? But as Peggy Noonan recently wrote, in falling in love with celebrity and personality, we are acting not like a tough and grounded country, but a frivolous and shallow one. And nowhere more so than the fawning media and the Hollywood class, who are in ecstasy at the thought of Oprah, one of their own in the White House, the ultimate revenge on the deplorables who put Trump there. Well, at least until Kelsey Clinton's ready. It's an interesting time, though. I continue to put it in the broader context of the huge changes that we're seeing.